I welcome you all in this session. Topic of this session is concept of cooperatives, and this session is the first session of the course Cooperative and Farmers Organization. In this session, we will discuss about the role of cooperatives and the meaning of the cooperative. Basically, we will discuss about the concept, what we mean by the concept of cooperatives. And you know, you all are aware that the cooperative concept is the basic requirement for our civilization. It is the basic concept which is required to fulfill the requirement of human civilization. And you all aware, you know, not only the human, it is also a important part of the living of the animals. You all are well aware about the, you know, small creatures like ants. They join together in a big way to carry a grain of sugar or food to achieve their common objective of meeting their food requirements by way of sharing the efforts and also the fruits. So cooperative is basically an organizing activities. In that activity, basically, you know, all people, all members, they share their efforts, their money, their resources, and the fruits they share, they divide among the members based on their efforts, based on their contribution. And you know, in the middle of the 18th century, there is one organization formed that is called as a International Cooperative Alliance, and this was a structured body to strengthen the cooperative movement world over. And you know, in the 18th century itself, the world community realized to form a organization like, you know, International Cooperative Alliances, and this alliance helped to promote the concept of the cooperative or the world over. So let us first understand what is the role of cooperatives. Before we proceed to the meaning of the cooperative, let us first understand what is the role of cooperatives. Cooperative movement started with the poor people so as to share the benefit with the poor in improving their quality of life. Actually, in the European countries, when the industrialized economy appears, industrialized economy emerged, and you know, poor people, they were left without any resources, and to help these poor people in the, you know, European countries, this cooperative concept emerged, and the purpose was to provide them the resources by pooling their resources. So in this way, this concept was emerged in the, you know, 18th century or 19th century, we can say. And these cooperatives are playing important role in Asian rural landscape, and it is particularly helping the Asian country also in developing the rural economy in the world or in the Asian country. And in India particularly, we have seen lot of improvement, lot of contribution from the cooperative societies. And it is basically it is a kind of enterprises which also incorporate the features of sociology, social structure, and contributed greatly to the development of the modern national and systematic agriculture production base, particularly in India. You know, we have seen the Green Revolution, in that this cooperative concept contributed a lot by supplying the fertilizers and other input to the farming society. And this, the cooperative movement has helped the country in enhancing the self-sufficiency of the major staple foods and strengthening the farmers' household economy by facilitating the market access and competitiveness to them. And this cooperative concept helped in adopting the technological innovation in the agriculture sector, because, you know, technology is always, you know, is resource requirement is there for technology adoption. And the farmers, you know, suppose a small farmers want to adopt purchase a tractor, and he don't have that money, and then the small farmers, they can come together and they can purchase a tractor in a cooperative way, in a group, and then when there is a requirement, they can take the tractor on the rental basis. So in this way, the cooperative society help them in adopting the technology for enhancement of the production. And another role of the cooperative society is it increased the democratic decision making process. When the cooperative organization is there in a village, so decision is taken based on the democratic principles. Every people have the right to say, to participate in the decision making process of that cooperative society. So the cooperative society also help in the leadership development in the rural economy. And what are the different areas which have been covered by the cooperative society? You know, and the cooperative societies are helping in the marketing of the product. They are helping in purchasing of the inputs for the farmer household or even the rural household. And you know, the cooperative society also do activity of depositing the saving and borrowing of money for the farmers, to the farmers, and providing housing facilities, or sometimes, you know, we have the housing societies also, that is also work on the cooperative principles. Sometimes cooperative also work in the area of, you know, providing protection to the member farmers, the member community, by providing the insurance and health services also. And the cooperative societies, it also help in the regional development where the society are working, by providing the marketing facility, by providing the input to the farmers, and by setting up the food processing industry. In this way, they are helping the rural economy, the agriculture economy. And you know, sometimes, you know, the cooperative also engage in the production activities, like the fertilizer production activity, a seed production activity, or some value-added production activities. So there are a number of way in which cooperative societies are helping the rural economy, the member farmers, the member community. Now let us move to the meaning of the cooperative society. Cooperative institutions are basically democratic, people-oriented organization rather than the capital oriented organization. You know, they are the business organization, cooperative are the business organization, but they are the democratic, people oriented organization. Their purpose is to serve the people, not to earn the money, like, you know, a private company, and they have the objective to earn profit. But in case of the cooperative society, the motive is to help the poor member, the members who are the part of the cooperative society. And cooperative are a universal form of the organization. It is available in almost all the country in the world, and peoples are using many way this cooperative society concept to help in their economic and social life. And you know, when we go to further understanding of this cooperative society meaning, a cooperative is a user-owned, user-controlled business that distribute benefit on the basis of use. It is distinct from the business or private business or a company in three way. You know, first is the cooperative is a basically user-owner concept. You know, persons who own, who finance the cooperative are those who use it. So the owner and user are the same person in case of the cooperative society. And second concept related to cooperative is that user control concept. The control of the cooperative is done by those who use the services of the cooperative. So here again, the decision is taken by the user of the cooperative society. So both the person are same. The controlling person and the user person, both are the same. The third concept is the user benefit concept. Benefit of the cooperative are distributed to the user on the basis of their use. The user benefit concept is often interpreted as the business at cost, because they have the motive to serve the member. They want to provide the services, and they do not have the motive to make the profit, to provide the costly thing to the members. So cooperative is basically an enterprise. Enterprise means it is basically a business. So a business organization that is owned and controlled by those who use its services. The net income, if any, of which is divided among the member in proportion to the use they make of its services. And here we can define what is the cooperative. This definition was given by the International Cooperative Congress in 1995. This is a universally accepted definition of the cooperative. A cooperative is an autonomous association of the person united voluntarily to meet their common economic, social, and cultural needs and aspirations through a jointly owned and democratically controlled enterprise. So this is basically autonomous association of the persons who joined the society voluntarily. There is no compulsion on them, and the purpose is to meet their common economic and social cultural needs, and decision is taken in the democratic way. So, you know, cooperation means people doing some of their economic activities together for their mutual benefit. So, you know, cooperative basically the some of the activities they do in a together way. You know, people just, you know, become a group and do some economic activity of production, marketing, purchasing inputs. So by inviting their efforts, people gain from one another ideas, talent, skills, energy, because and the pool become a one. The talent of the different people, the talent of the skilled people, they come together and they become a full of energy, full of ideas, full of activities, and in this way they become a benefit from the cooperative actions. So in this way they are able to achieve the results which they could not achieve alone. So in the cooperative manners, if they do activities in a group, they will able to achieve the output which they cannot achieve when they do in individual basis. So here, you know, this definition, what we have read earlier, a cooperative is a autonomous association of persons united voluntarily to meet their common economic, social and cultural needs and aspirations through a jointly owned and democratically controlled enterprise. So this is basically an identity statement about the cooperative. If any organization who is following this definition, we can say this is a cooperative. So this definition is a minimal statement, not a full description of the perfect cooperative. So people or cooperative, they have the flexibility to modify their activity, and they have to definitely must follow the basic principle of cooperative. So this definition also help in the, you know, drafting the legislation, educating the farmers or preparing the textbooks. If they are doing some additional activity, if they want to form the new cooperative organization or cooperative society, they must follow this definition in their formulation process. So these are the different characteristics of the cooperative society. We can say the cooperative is autonomous organization. It is an independent of the government and private firms as possible. So there is no interferences from the government side, from the private companies, and it is a association of persons. And you know, the persons come together to form a cooperative society, and the cooperative society, they have the freedom to choose or to define the person, who is the person who can become the member of the society. They can decide while the registering their the act and by formulating their memorandum, they can decide, they can define the who can join the this society. This person basically are united voluntarily. There is no compulsion on the members to join a society or cooperative society. Members are free to join or to leave the society. Then member of cooperatives are basically to meet their common economic, social and cultural needs. So this cooperative society is helping them to provide a better way of life, and by providing them cultural, intellectual or spiritual leadership or spiritual activities, and cooperative can benefit their members and contribute their community. So in this way, basically purpose is to meet the members' requirement through the joint activity. Then cooperative is a basically jointly owned and democratically controlled enterprises. Cooperative control is distributed among the member on a democratic basis. So every person or every member of the cooperative society, they have an equal right to say, they have the right to vote. And so in this way, the process of decision taking is a democratic process. And this dual characteristics of ownership and the democratic control are particularly important differentiating the cooperatives from the other kind of organizations. And here you can see some of the basic values which are required for the functioning of the cooperatives or cooperative sectors or cooperative organization. There are some basic cooperative values like self-help, self-responsibility, democracy, equality, equity, solidarity, and there are some ethical values which we have derived from our ancient society or from the civilizations. We have developed some social values in our human being, like honesty, openness, social responsibility, caring for others. So these are some of the values which are required for the successful functioning of the cooperative society. And here we can discuss about these different cooperative values in details. Like self-help is the most important cooperative values which is required, and self-help is basically all the people, they strive to control their own destiny. So here people come together to control their own destiny. They decide what they want to achieve, and for that particular objective or for particular outcomes they want to, they become a group and they want to try, or they strive basically to control their own destiny. And individual development can take place only in the association with others. You know, individual person do not have all complete skills or knowledge. So, and then if they work together, they can add skills or knowledge of other person in their activity, and then they can strive, they can achieve the output. And individual develop skills and continuing education and development of all those involved with them. So through this cooperative values, they can develop their skills by continuing education, by learning from the other persons who are the member of the society. And self-responsibility is the other cooperative value. Members assume responsibility for their cooperatives, for its establishment, for its continuing vitality. So every members, they have some responsibility to work in the society and assume some responsibility basically, so that the society work for its vitality. And cooperative are based on the equality principles, and all members are equal. You know, there is no rich or poor. We cannot differentiate the based on the their socio-economic status of the members. We cannot differentiate upon between the members based on their richness or poorness or some caste, creed. All this is not applicable in case of the cooperative society. Then achieving equity within the cooperative society is the most important thing, and it is always continuing process or never ending challenge, and all members should be treated equitably in how they are rewarded for their participation in a cooperative. This is the principle of equity. And then solidarity is another thing. Basically, in the solidarity, all the people are united. They do activity collectively, and all members, including the employees and non-members, should be treated fairly. This is the solidarity about the functioning of the cooperative sectors or cooperative society. And you know, responsibility for the collective of the its member, it is basically solidarity. So here again we can understand the what we mean by the collective action. Society is basically a collective action. Society is basically doing the activity in a group or with togetherness of the all its members. So cooperation is basically working together. Many people, they become a one group and they do activity together. Cooperation means living, thinking, working together. So they do lot of activity together, even they think together, even they work together. So this is basically cooperative and cooperation. And it is a special method of doing business. So it is in a special type of business activity. Here person or individual members, they share their efforts, time, money, and based on that activities, they get the benefit from that efforts, time and money. It is working together to learn to live in our human society harmoniously. So it from the cooperative actions or collective action, we learned how we can live in a society in harmonious way. Then cooperation existed even before the man came to this world, this earth. It is much older than the man himself. So this concept of cooperativeness, working togetherness, is older than the man himself. And cooperation existed in the even animal worlds. Like I gave example of ant. And so you know, ant become do activity in a group to have the fruits of carrying a food grains or sugar grains. So the cornerstone of cooperative is a mutual help. So mutual help is the most important aspect, and it is to survive with dignity and purpose. And again, collective action means a social order in which man is free from the class struggle. Here we cannot represent the people based on the caste and creed. And this collective action or cooperative organization is a form of business organization in which there is no exploitation, because users are the owners, users are the controller of the society. So there is no exploitation in the cooperative society, and organization in which the membership enjoy this special privilege and concession conferred by the law. So they are the member who enjoy the some privilege of becoming a member, because only the member can participate in the activity of the cooperative society or cooperatives. And you know, this meaning of the cooperative society or cooperation is still being discussed all over the world. You know, always some changes or improvement in the meaning of these cooperatives. and cooperative movement is however spreading and operating in various places with varying degree of success. Some of the societies are very successful, some of the societies are not giving much result or successful result, we can say. The cooperative movement has existed because of its ideal principles and characteristic features. So, but this movement of cooperative movement is spreading throughout the world because of its ideals, because of its principles, or because of its characteristic features. And here, similar to the cooperative society, there is one more concept, that is the cooperative, you know, Section 25 companies. Section 25 companies also, you know, working in the togetherness, the people become a group and they join a group and establish a company. So there is a little difference between cooperative and Section 25 companies. Section 25 companies are those companies which are formed for the sole purpose of promoting commerce, science, art, religion, charity, or any other useful object, and have been granted a license by the central government recognizing them as such. So it is basically a company which are formed for the sole purpose. There is only one purpose of promoting either the commerce, art, science, religious activities, charities, or any other purposeful objects. And such companies should intend to apply its profit, if any, or other income only in promoting its objectives. So if there is any income by Section 25 company, it should be applied, it should be used for the getting this objective for which the company was established. So only in promoting its objective, this is the major purpose of the Section 25 company, and must also provide payment of dividend to its members. So there is no profit distribution to the member of a Section 25 company. So there are some privilege which were given to the Section 25 company. There are some key benefits are there, you know, many privileges and exemption under company laws given to the Section 25 companies, exemption from the requirement of minimum paid up capitals, the exemption of stamp duty for registration, and non-application of the company auditor's report orders 2003. Then registered partnership firm can be a member in its own capacity, and tax deduction to the donor of the company under Section 80G of the Income Tax Act. So if any person is giving some donation to Section 25 company, that is exempted to pay the income tax under Section 80G of the Income Tax Act. And you know, there are some key features of the Section 25 company. The important are like profit or income of the company shall be applied for the purpose of the promotion of the its main objective. The company is related to do some charity activities, so all the profits should be used for the charity purpose only. There is no other use of that profit or that income. And declaration of dividend or distribution of profit to the promoters is not allowed under Section 25 companies. So there is no income distribution or profit distribution to the member of the Section 25 company. No member shall be appointed as a remunerated officer. So, you know, there is no salary paid to the member, there is no income distribution to the member. If the payment can be made in the form of only reimbursement, which the members they have made from their pocket for expenses of some daily activities, that has to be reimbursed to the by the company, but there is no income distribution to the member of the Section 25 company. Or if there is any alteration is required in the memorandum of the company, it has to be approved by the central government. And here we can differentiate between the Section 25 company and cooperatives. And Section 25 companies basically are free-wheeling business organization which do not make any profit. Their purpose is not to make any profit. If there is any profit, there is to be plugged back to the business, and there is no minimum requirement to establish this company. Like in cooperative society, we have certain guidelines to form the cooperative society. Cooperative society, on the other hand, are formed by the member who should be qualified to be the member. Only the there is some definition of the person who can become a member of the society. So only that become a member of the society. Cooperatives law require a minimum number of members to be form a cooperative. You know, there is a structure are there, how many women participants, women members should be there. So all these guidelines should be followed while formulating a cooperative society. And you know, cooperative can distribute their profit among their members and offer dividend while such is not possible in the case of Section 25 company. So in case of the cooperatives, they can distribute their profit to the members, among the members, that is not possible in case of the Section 25 company. Now, time to sum up the session. You know, we understand the role of cooperative society. The cooperative societies are important not only in economic activity, it is also important for their social upliftment, and for in a regional development, and it also bring them the democratic principles. So all these things are very important for overall development of the human being, and they bring the concept of togetherness so that they can live in the harmonious way. Then we have also discussed the area of operation of the cooperatives. The cooperatives are working in the field of the marketing of the produce, in the supplying of the inputs, in the production activity, agro-processing activities. There are a number of ways in which, you know, cooperative societies are working. And we have understood in detail the meaning of the cooperative society. They are the autonomous association of the people who join together to meet their social, economic and other objectives. So the principle are that this organization are controlled in democratic way. Every people, every member have a equal right to say in decision taking, and profits are shared among the member based on their contributions. And we have also understood the meaning of the cooperative or collective actions. Then we have also discussed about the Section 25 companies. I know these companies are basically, you know, little different from the cooperative society. Cooperative society, in the cooperative society, we can distribute the profit to the member, but in case of Section 25 company, we cannot distribute the profit to the member. Only we can provide in some reimbursement to them, which they have made some expenses on doing the activity of the Section 25 company. So in the cooperative is the very important activity for overall economic development of the society, and the cooperative concept helped us in the agro-based sector, agro sector, agriculture sector particularly, in promoting the agriculture activity, in promoting the self-sufficiency in food grain production. You know, during the Green Revolution period, this concept has helped a lot in adopting the yielding varieties, in providing the fertilizer. In some of the places we have seen this cooperative society has helped in providing the irrigation infrastructure, the farm machinery, particularly it is very important for the small farmers. You know, small farmers, they do not have the sufficient resources for meeting the all requirement of their family or their rural societies. So they can purchase the farm machinery or some input in the group, and they can distribute that machinery or the input based on their requirement. With this, I thank you all. Thank you very much.